Du East River, je vous retrouve aujourd'hui pour une spéciale New York, incluant les bons plans de Manhattan et les endroits incontournables de Brooklyn qui devient vraiment the place to go. Alors nous allons commencer avec l'Upper East Side et le spa de Cornelia dans le Surrey Hotel, puis on enchaînera avec une petite boutique de jeunes créateurs tenue par de jeunes femmes passionnées par la mode et l'art. Et puis on arrivera à Brooklyn et là, je vais faire l'interview d'Eliott qui est devenu mannequin homme et nous allons déguster toutes les saveurs et les spécialités des restaurants à Brooklyn. Puis on enchaîne avec les petits choux et les merveilleux aux caprices de Sophie. On revient ensuite à Manhattan et là je vous emmène dans la boutique de Vintage qui cartonne à New York. Toutes les fashion addicts viennent pour louer leurs robes des galas et des charities. Et on terminera par Bagatelle pour une soirée rocambolesque, Ice Watch Hut et une ambiance détonnante. Who you suckers think you're tripping with? Yes, I'm the boss. 745, white on white, that's Rick Ross. I cut them wide, I cut them long, I cut them fat. I keep them coming back, we keep them coming back. I'm in the distribution, I'm like Atlantic. I got the pretty things flying across the Atlantic. I know Pablo. Every day I'm hustling, 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 every day I'm hustling. Sur le Bowery, je vous emmène maintenant dans la boutique d'Agni et Barstow. Vous allez voir ces deux jeunes femmes irrésistibles et passionnées par la mode. On avait marre de tous ces designers qui se répètent. Alors elles ont réuni des jeunes créateurs à l'international. Vous allez voir, c'est l'adresse parfaite si vous êtes une fashion addict.
Welcome to Dagny and Barstow.
So where the name is coming from?
Everyone asks. We don't really have an answer.
There's no real answer. We wanted something that sounded a little masculine and not like just another, you know, silly girly store. So we kind of went with it.
Is it true, because I can see that the bar is still here, that it was the favorite club of Lenny Kravitz?
No, he owned it.
He owned the club. Yeah. I thought it was a mistake.
No. Lenny Kravitz owned this nightclub with Denzel Washington.
And that's the original bar.
So that's the only thing you kept, the original bar?
The chandelier.
We pretty much kept everything. We loved the space the way it was.
Lenny.
No, but when we found the space, it was all dark green and like this really tacky wallpaper. The like piece that's above the bar was covered in green pleather. It was wild. Yeah. And there was like a crazy purple shag carpet VIP room in the back.
Called the Kitty Box.
Oh, wow.
Terrible, terrible things happened.
What is your aesthetic? I mean, it's funny because as you said, it's not like ultra girly or very feminine, but you have some feminine, you know, accessories that you can mix with your own style. I mean, you both have a very specific style.
Yeah, I mean, neither of us are girly girls, so coming into
it. I can tell you're like, hey, hi, Juliette. No, I'm kidding.
But we just wanted to have something different. We got really sick of the whole shopping scene in New York.
It's about like finding the sophisticated designers and then adding in those sort of crazy fun touches like Au Jour Le Jour, who's a new designer for us. and just sort of making the look your own. You know, it's not about being a head-to-toe designer. You know, it should have a sense of humor. With Annalise.
I love their glasses. Their glasses with the monkeys.
Amazing.
That's so cool.
The like pants outfit also.
Oh. You better believe in yourself when you're gonna wear that.
Exactly. It's nice though. We love that line because they also do really beautiful, sophisticated, more traditional pieces. Mm. Like they do this amazing tunic sweater, and you know it's just incredibly beautiful, made in Italy.
Yeah.
And a really great winter piece.
No, I mean it's a nice.
So we like that they can do both.
Yeah, definitely. Actually a very good selection that you did because they really bring another like funny touch.
Yeah, this is just a like insane shoe. We didn't realize
I love
that...
this word, it's insane.
I mean, it's so fun, and these are supposed to be hands that are
It was surrealist inspired, but we actually loved it because it sort of had this Egyptian element to it as well. And another one of our designers, Maria Francesca Pepe, did a whole like Egyptian inspired Evil Eye collection, and we thought it went really nicely with it.
I mean, I think it goes nicely also, you know, with your bag. So you were saying that, I mean, the beauty of discovering designers and new up-and-coming creators is that the department stores are coming here and they get your inspiration and then, you know, it's everywhere.
Well, Barney's has picked up a number of lines that we were the first to carry in the U.S. here.
And I love these bags.
I like that color with your dress.
Love that color. I know they're coming. Is it the same designer?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, on dirait que je suis une vraie gamine dans la boutique en train de tout
essayer.
I look like a little girl, you know, in a candy store.
Yeah.
But I mean, they're just like super modern. I mean, that's what I love, you know. Today, I'm kind of tired of the big brands and the bags because in New York, I mean, I think it's the same thing in Paris and in London. Every single woman carries the same bag.
Yeah, it gets really boring.
It's so boring, it's so impersonal. I mean, that's what we want. And I think also the young generation, you know, we want like little bags that nobody has, but it looks very nice because of the quality and the way it's made. It could be like an Alexander Wang.
Yeah, she's really cool.
That's
What's
my
her
favorite
name?
One.
Reese Hudson is the line.
Reese, you gotta be good.